survival.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, and both your parents are medical specialists.
Yes, they are cardiologists.
They are cardiologists.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So their parents did not say that they should also become a doctor.
Sir, they were very open-minded at that time, and initially they persuaded me to become a doctor. But later, when I mean confronted with them, and then they allowed me to pursue.
Did it require a confrontation?
Mutual understanding.
Mutual understanding. Be careful of the words that you use. They may be taken in the interview. Okay, now Anmol, our government is talking so much about this financial inclusion. So, what do you understand by financial inclusion?
So the term financial inclusion means to have the services of banking, let's say credit, insurance, and other services to the areas where these services are not there, such as rural areas in our country. And so financial inclusion also requires education and financial literacy among the stakeholders, and also about there is lack of infrastructure and participation of banks and other non-banking institutions in the rural areas. This is basically what is the essence of financial.
Now, supposing there is a person, when will I say that this person is financially included?
So, one of the basic tests would be that the person has a bank account. This, I think.
That's all?
So, and has basic credit availability or is able to use that banking account.
Okay.
This will also be included.
Anything more?
I cannot think of
it. Financial inclusion basically means having access to bank, number two, having access to credit, then having access to insurance. Right. So all these they combine, and then access to this health facility. That is why government is not simply saying that you open their account. Opening that account was the first step. After that, a card was issued. Issuing that card actually meant was they will be using that card and they will get accident insurance. Then they came up with a scheme for their life insurance. You pay this much rupees, very nominal amount, 200 rupees, and you will have life insurance. Okay, so all these things they were brought in to ensure that they are financially included. So it is not just opening up one saving account. That is why the government also said that they can have overdraft in that saving account. Because they have to be given access to credit also. Now if the question arises is that they don't have anything in their account. And I am giving the banker suppose. Giving them overdraft to the extent of say 5,000 rupees. So should I do it as a banker? My money is at stake.
So as a banker, there are a lot of costs associated with giving overdraft and other facilities. However, if we look from the perspective of the number of customers the bank will be gaining if the financial inclusion succeeds in our country. So I think a balanced cost-benefit analysis have to be done by the bank, and on the basis of it, they have to reach at the overdraft, the money that they are giving to the rural households.
Supposing as a bank, I stick out a board, open an account, take overdraft of 5,000 rupees. Everybody who's passing by will come. So I end up giving 5,000 rupees to say 2,000 people, I have given lakhs of rupees. So that is no good way of acquiring customers. Because that money may not come back, that entire money.
If bank is giving these options of overdraft, bank also have to look into the exact details of the people to which they are lending. They can use their basic land accounts or land details of the areas have been can be taken up. And
if you go through that carefully, it says you have to operate that account for some time. That operation is required so that when it comes to know about it, about you, about your behavior, then only that will happen.
Yes, sir, a credit analysis of the
that analysis happens within that 6 months. So that part is to be done. Not just that anybody comes open the account and gets money. A very good role has in this been assigned to payment banks. What are these payment banks?
So payment banks are a type of differentiated banks whose main purpose is to give banking facilities in the form of transfer of money that can be used by migrants and other areas. And so they are a new category that has allowed diversification of banks.
There are some restrictions on payment banks, or anybody can act as a payment bank?
So there are restrictions, certain capital requirements are there. And also the people who can be the promoters of payment bank have been also been restricted. And again, requirements of requirements set by RBI that is implicable to other banks are have also been different for these payment banks. And the lending facilities and credit taking activities have also been restricted.
How, to what extent they have been restricted?
Sir, for the promoters, it is around they must have a capital of 100 crore rupees. Second, sir, I do not recall the exact provision.
Okay. Supposing I open a payment bank account, so can I keep 10 lakh rupees in that?
No, sir, I
will not know. Okay. Then there is a lot of talk about this DBT. You know what is DBT?
It's a direct benefit transfer.
Why this DBT?
Sir, it has been seen that government spends a lot of money in subsidy and other purposes which is given to people. Direct benefit transfer is a method of transferring those money, and there are various advantages of it. First is it reduces the administrative cost of the government. It secondly creates a channel in which directly money can be transferred to the people, and it reduces the number of intermediaries, which in turn check the corruption and errors of inclusion and exclusion if the data is correct. So these are the major benefits of having DBT in this.
Supposing I take a very small example, this DBT for gas emission, supply of gas is going to account. I open two accounts at two places. I can get two cylinders. So that DBT has been misused. What to what protection is there against such?
So the gas cylinders are given to a one member of a particular household. That too also, I think the female member gets it. And based on the data from SECC data, this number has been arrived, sir. And I think this is the provision.
Something about Aadhaar CD.
Sir, Aadhaar CD. I'm very sorry.
Gas. Connection also that Aadhaar has to be sealed, and that the account also the Aadhaar has to be sealed. Immediately it will come out that the person is having two connections or two names. Aadhaar sealing, that was the purpose of introducing Aadhaar sealing.
On what physics was your optional course? Textile technology was part of IIT. Can you explain the theory of relativity in a very, for a layman? I'm not a physics student. I read it several times, but I was not able to really understand it. Can you explain to me in very, very simple terms?
So the
general theory of relativity, no special theory, just general theory.
So the general theory of relativity tells about the motion of objects in a non-relativistic frame, by which I mean that the frames which are accelerating and the objects are moving at a very high speed. And second is that it links the theory of gravity with that of space-time and how gravity is able to influence the behavior of particles like photons. To give you an example of it, sir, if a light passes through an area which has been bended by gravity, by a very heavy mass object such as black hole, the light will bend. Light will bend as the space-time is curved because of the mass of that object. And to visualize this, we can use the example of a mosquito net and place a ball there.
Mosquito
and,
net?
We can place a mosquito net and a heavy object there. The space-time can be imagined as a mosquito net which is bent because of that heavy object.
Mosquito net, you are...
The top surface
top,
of that.
Okay.
And if I place a ball there, it will get a curved shape. And if I place a coin or a marble there and let it roll, marble be the photon, and we can see the path of marble being getting curved because of the mass of that object. Because that mass has bent the space and time. The fabric of space.
And that stone thing, you repeat again?
Sir, the stone can be seen as a photon, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Because it the light will get bent as the space has bended.
Mm-hmm.
The path is bended and it will get a curved like motion of the photon. This is also true for objects like moon and earth.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the basic reason of the elliptical path of the earth's motion. Mm-hmm.
Okay, how do you see the implementation of Ayushman Bharat? And do you think it will be, because the target is very, very ambitious, covering 10 crore families, 50 crore people. Do we have the wherewithal? Do we have a doctor? Do we have hospitals?
So, Ayushman Bharat scheme has two components. First is having 150,000 health and wellness centers. And second is that of providing tertiary and secondary care to the people who will be insured under the scheme. So, as you mentioned that do we have the infrastructure or the capacity? Coming to that point, sir, we lack the basic infrastructure in rural areas and in tier 2 and tier 3 cities as well. And the number of doctors in those areas are less. So, however, if we look at the model of the Ayushman scheme, it has empaneled private and government hospitals, which will increase the coverage. Second, the insurance in itself will reduce the out-of-pocket expenditure, which is around 60% in our country, which is one of the highest. And it has, again, sir, the provision of having more doctors in these areas are needed and have to be supplemented in the scheme. This has to be, there has to be a comprehensive measure necessary.
You tell me, the farmer distress, you know, is a serious problem. Serious problem, it has been going on for decades, despite so many efforts by different governments, state governments, central government scheme, loan waivers. It has been happening for quite some time, but farmer distress continues. What you think, tell me two steps in short term, two in mid term, and two in long term, which you as district collector would take in your district so that farmer distress is minimized. It can be combated to a large extent. Tell me some practical suggestions which are implementable.
The short term measures that I think are the most important. First is that of realizing the prices that the farmers should get of their produces. And this can be done through having ENAM and rural Grameen agriculture markets to reduce the number of middlemen there, and farmers getting their produce selling directly. Second immediate step could be that of implementation of schemes such as Bhavantar Bhuktan or Ritu Bandhu scheme by Telangana and Madhya Pradesh. These are the immediate measures.
This Government of India has already done, yesterday only Honorable Prime Minister released the first tranche of
PM Kisan.
So
at the middle level solutions would be that we need to diversify our agricultural income. By having funds for animal husbandry and other areas, milk procurement and fishery could be implemented. Second is that of having irrigation cover. So Madhya Pradesh, the state in which I belong to, has doubled its irrigation coverage, and also the road network has been, 1 lakh kilometers of road have been, rural roads have been created, which has increased the procurement as well as the production of the producer. In the long term, sir, there is a need to have a structural change in our economy, as 49% of our population is contributing around only 15% to the GDP, which leads to a problem of disguised unemployment and that of underemployment, and need to have rural industrialization, which has been one of the major areas where we have to focus on. And sir, there is a need to have reform in entire agriculture productivity and improve the income or the economics of every farm. By which I mean that farmers must get that their produce have to be diversified. They must have irrigation coverage. They must have insurance. They must have credit facilities. And on the other hand, they must have ancillary or other sources of income so as to diversify their income generation.
This MG Narega, there is allegation by particularly rich farmers class in Punjab, Haryana, that MG Narega has adversely impacted the agriculture. Because now agriculture labor is not available. People from Bihar, Eastern UP, who are working as farm laborers in the farms of Punjab and Haryana. So that is not happening. So as a result, agriculture is suffering in these two states, particularly maybe Western Rajasthan also, Western UP also. So what do you say?
Sir, MG Narega has a negative consequences as it leads to a higher demand of income by the workers, agricultural laborers per se. It also is linked with inflation and rising produce of the farmer.
Why do you call it a negative impact? Farmers are entitled to a good remuneration.
Laborers.
Laborers are, why should they be paid low? I mean, that is the one of the objectives of MG Narega, that they can negotiate higher wages.
Yes.
From the known farm sectors or from the private farmers.
Sir, I was saying it from the point of view of the farmers who have to pay more and they are not getting the remuneration that they should be getting from the produce that they are producing. Sir.
You understand one thing, that no small or marginal farmers, you know the definition of small farmer, you know the definition of marginal farmers. So no farmer, which are almost 80% of the total holdings in India. 2 hectares, small farmers, less than 1 hectare, marginal farmers. And these are the people who never engage the farm laborers. Their entire family work. And even if they engage, it is a very small scale. That's why I qualified my question by saying that complaint is from the rich farmers.
Okay.
Punjab, Haryana, who themselves want to stay in Chandigarh and urban areas and want to take cheap labor from Bihar, UP. And particularly from that angle, I have this question.
I'm sorry, sir, I do not know the exact reason of the protest.
Okay. Have you heard of a scheme called Kusum?
No, sir, I cannot recall.
Then, Subhagya scheme, you know, that electrification, household level electrification. Do you think that we should be able to achieve by March 31st, which was promised by Honorable Prime Minister? What is the leftover number of households?
Sir, I do not recall the exact number of households being electrified. So, however, the progress has been very good on this.
Thank you.
Anmol, who all have been affected by this Indo-Pak tension in our country?
Sir, these Indo-Pak tensions have very negative consequences on the large sections of our society. First, I would say that army has been impacted. Second is Kashmiris have been boycotted and have been under various challenges after the Pulwama attacks recently. So also the rise of terrorism has had impact on the basic civilians which happened in Mumbai attacks. Also the people of Jammu and Kashmir have been majorly impacted because of India-Pak tension.
Majorly affected means that they are now more militant or more passive?
Sir, there have been the trends of rising militancy in Kashmir, rising infiltration of terrorist groups who have come into Kashmir and brainwashed the citizens of our country. And also, sir, there have been issues with the border villages who have to be deallocated recently.
How will you, as a SP of one particular district in the border areas, how will you tackle this of rising militancy or the feeling of this?
Sir, as SP, I'll frame a policy of which have short-term measures and long-term measures. So in the short term, there is a need to check the sources of radicalization, be it social media, be it infiltration, be it the activities of youth, that is drone builders and other. This has to be done through strengthening the investigations and other things. In the long term, sir, there is a trust deficit in the youth of Kashmir, which has to be solved through comprehensive socio-economic solutions by, de-radicalization is also necessary along with this.
Do you think others who have been in the law enforcement, they have not done this? They must have done the same thing what you are thinking. What would be the new thing which you think? Because policy, framing, short term and long term, this has all been analyzed, this has all been checked. What as a young SP, your way of handling?
So firstly, the implementation of everything that has been done or is being done has to be strengthened, sir. And particularly, sir, as a SP, I think people-to-people connections can be strengthened by music, art and culture and sports, sir. I think this can strengthen the feeling of community building in Kashmir.
I asked you how. This is what you're telling me. How? Say music and culture. There's cross-firing going on and you say, let's have music recitals.
Not that time of the dispute.
When tension is there, then?
So there are various other means in which these exercises can be done by having festivals, the literary festivals or music and art festivals. So Kashmir team is one of the top teams in I leagues of in the football. Sir, this is a positive step, sir.
You mean to say whenever there is a tension between the two countries or any two countries, they should start doing this, have a football match, bring the people together like this. We are isolating Pakistan, we are boycotting them, we expect they'll accept an invitation at this stage.
Sir, I'm sorry that I meant these for the Kashmiri youths to come into the fold of nations, not for the Indo-Pakistan.
My question was how will you, the culture program which you're anticipating, will ease the Indo-Pak tension? That is how you will do it. No idea. Anyway, let's go to another question. Once you become the DM, how are you going to prevent data breaches in your department or under whosoever is in camera, even in the ministry?
The data encryption can be used. And second is that of IP protocol system, which can be intra-department and so as to avoid infiltration. Third is collaborating with private bodies and other institutes who provide these protection systems such as antivirus and other malware protection. Fourth is that to training of the every individual so as to avoid getting breached by malware and other siphoning acts which are done through emails and other systems. And fifthly, sir, private email system can be introduced, which is being done by various government departments.
We are staying in one of the poshest localities, Arera Colony in Bhopal.
Yes.
Now, this Arera Colony, I am told, is also has a lot of bureaucrats.
Sir, bureaucrats in Bhopal are basically situated in Charimli.
Where is it?
Sir, in Charimli.
Charimli.
It is named on a hill that is called.
Yes. Charimli.
Yes.
Arera, then of course, is a posh locality. It's a big house.
Yes.
Do you think that the posh localities in a place like Bhopal segregates the people?
So true, sir. Any locality which is poor has led to segregation on the basis of income of people. However, Bhopal has a very syncretic culture where people intermingle along various lines. And I think, the housing has been lines of segregation, because as we see, if we compare the areas of slums as compared to Arera Colony, there is a segregation. And yes, sir, I agree to this.
Okay, Anmol, my last question would be that you have been reading newspapers. Now, tell me very frankly, when a boy becomes an IAS or he tops the IAS, and that too from a rickshaw puller, son of a rickshaw puller, son of a, generally the media highlights it, son of a rickshaw puller becomes an IAS, which means the people who are not knowing also from which hue he is coming, that is public now. Now two things are there, that listen, this poor man has got this right, so we come to know that he is from very poor family. Second is that he is wiser than the hard working parents whom he had, say farmers or rickshaw pullers or somebody, maybe a clerk. This happens, right? But in case of a joint secretary's son becomes into IAS, we don't have a headline like this. We believe that since he was an IAS, his son has got an invisible right to become an IAS. He has got all the credentials here. How do you take this into account?
Sir, true, these reports are there, but in my opinion, sir, the person who has come from very poorer backgrounds or has faced socioeconomic disabilities have to fight more. They have to, go against the odds and have to work really hard. I'm not saying that the person from a richer family will not have to work hard, but there are other factors which he has to overcome as belonging to a poorer section. And I think, sir, this is the reason why his success is highlighted more as compared to the person who has got good education, good background, family support. He do not have to look for his alternative opportunities. While this person, I think he has overcome a lot, and the stakes are very high for that person.
So why don't we say he's struggled and he's firm, he's strong? We don't say that. Why? Do you want a media change of these kind of reports?
Yeah,
these are detrimental.
Yes, sir. True.
To the person. Forever he'll be taken as, because I saw a picture of that lady, the first IAS officer who was a rickshaw puller, and she was taking a, riding
a
fast.
That's a fake.
That was there. And somehow these reports which I'm talking about are almost true, because they interview the parents also at times, So do you foresee or do you think a change is necessary for the media management?
Sir, I think there are both positive and negative consequences to it.
Positive.
Yes, sir. It is a motivation for other people from similar backgrounds that they can also achieve through hard work, through motivation and through perseverance. In terms of negative impact is that it is categorizing people on the basis of their income and other family backgrounds, and relating, or is also against the people who are from good backgrounds, that see, you can, he has done it, you can't do it, something like a, there is,
and on both the IAS son has also done,
yes,
sufficient,
yes,
labor,
yes,
which the other person also done,
yes,
but one is being highlighted,
yes,
that is the problem, because this nation is thrill hungry. They're not news the same.
Yes,
he gets a job, he gets a job. So we are a thrill hungry nation, not news hungry. So you want foresee a change? Do you want, if you're in IMB ministry?
Sir, I think the media have a perception of sensationalizing the news so as to get more number of viewers. But in my opinion, sir, his struggles and things have been highlighted. However, there have to be certain regulations. So
I'm going to cut it short. You're right. Media has sensationalizing the things, but as till the time you don't occupy the chair of civil servant, you'll be banking and only taking information from the media. Right?
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. You are a textile engineer, basically. What are the options, career options available to a textile engineer?
Sir, a textile engineer can go into research into his own field. Second option is that of getting an engineering job as a in our textile firm. Third is, I think, that of...
Which are the prominent textile firms?
Sir, in India there are Vardhman Textiles, Raymond's is there, and other textiles industry who are set up here. For example, like Levi's have also established their plant. And
Are you aware of the new national textile policy?
Yes.
What is it?
Sir, the new textile policy has basic agenda of diversification of our textile produce in terms of shifting from a cotton based industry to a man-made industry. Second is that of providing technology capital to our most decentralized textile industry, which is power loom and hand loom. Third aspect is to skill the workers and provide employment opportunities. Fourth is that of giving credit, basic insurance and social security to the workers. Fifth is to amend the labor law so as to attract FDI and other purposes. Mm-hmm. And sixth is to diversify our exports, as textile is one of the largest export-oriented industry in the country, to get more FTAs from EU and other countries and ASEAN and other countries.
Mm-hmm. Okay, have you ever been to a textile firm?
Yes, sir. During my internship, I went to.
Which company was it?
Sir, Ashok Textiles in Bareilly.
In Bareilly. Okay. Did they give you any stipend or you just...
No sir, it was an internship in my third year, which is a compulsory part of our curriculum, and they didn't provide us any.
Why only Bareilly? Why not elsewhere? In Madhya Pradesh there was no such thing.
Sir, in Madhya Pradesh there were industries near Bhopal and Mandiki, as I mentioned, Vardhman and other industries. I visited those industries, but I preferred Bareilly as we had certain accommodation and other provisions there, and I'm sure.
Okay. If you have gone ever to a textile industry, you must be aware of the challenges that face the labor. You talked of the labor reforms. What kind of challenges are being faced? Toxic fumes, toxic things, you know.
First is that of health hazard, as you know. First is that of health hazard. Textile, there are a lot number of fibers which are in the air, which affect the lungs of a person. Second is that of working condition. They have to work for long hours. Third is that of wages.
How many long hours?
Sir, 10 hours is the minimum.
So normal is 8.
Sir, normal is 8, but they have to do dual shifts and other things also. Sir.
Is it not illegal?
Sir, the government recently changed the laws and allowed them to overtime from 50 hours a week to 100 hours a week. So this has been a major reform that government has.
And do they get extra benefits?
Yes, sir. They get extra remuneration for this.
And what about toxic chemicals?
Yes, sir.
Respiratory problems?
Sir, respiratory problems are there. The dyes that they are using is polluting environment, air and other. The fumes that are liberated. And so one of the largest environmentally unfriendly industry is textile industry.
This firm which you visited in Bareilly, did they manage their industrial waste, industrial influence? There is always some place where you can throw your industrial effluents.
Yes. So the effluents are basically from the dyeing aspect of the textile industry. My internship was focused on knitting and weaving aspect. They send their products to other industries for dyeing and So as such, there were no effluent plants because they didn't use that.
There was no dying activity here.
No, sir, because the value chain was broken. Sir.
Okay. Thank you. And when your interview is over, our feedback. Yeah. Please, you speak rather fast. Please slow down. Ah, you will get the
video. You will get.
Ask them to send it as early as possible. Your interview is on 25th of March.
Yes.
So slow down the tempo of your voice. That is very, very important. And dress also.
Sir, I'll be changing the dress.
What kind of suit will you be?
Sir, it is dark green.
Dark grey.
Yes.
So this should be a grey tie also.
Yes.
Yes.
I have a blue tie, sir. Blue
no,
plain tie.
Purchase a grey one.
Okay.
It goes very well with the grey suit. And it should be plain tie, no design, nothing.
Okay.
And the shirt should be white.
Yeah, yes, sir. This
that's okay. You must. I think you'll be able to do very well. And your hand movement also were visible.
Okay, sir.
At times, that please control your keep your hands on the thighs and the eye content. I think you also realized you were not looking at others.
Yes.
When you were answering his questions, you did not look at others. So please take care of that. And which are the textile industries in Madhya Pradesh? Read the socio-economic parameters of Madhya Pradesh. There has been, after the new government took over, there was a name changing of certain schemes launched by the previous government. So what do you think of that? Which are the schemes? What is the new name? Think about that. And I think that's all from my side.
Amol, your knowledge base is wonderful. Very articulate, very balanced. I see no reason why you should make a very good grade this time. Tie, I think.
Tie,
you have to go for it. Suit color, coat color is also.
It's
changed.
It's very old.
Yeah, it's long having a different suit. But it is a new suit.
Sir, I purchased a new one.
You have purchased. But do wear it 3 to 4 times before. You go for that interview.
Yes, sir.
But nothing should be new.
Yes, sir.
Whatever you feel awkward, your shoes, your shirt, etc., you should at least use 2 to 3 times.
Okay.
Okay, and then otherwise you're absolutely not good material for foreign services. And the knowledge is supplied. All the best.
So, and all the dress is quite good, you have very good dress. But did you notice that you were sitting? You also tripped.
Yes, sir. Why, sir?
Why did that happen?
Sir, I didn't see there's another.
My feeling was that while you were trying to sit, you were also trying to unbutton your coat.
Yes, sir.
Your attention was more on the coat rather than sitting here. So this should not happen there. So why? How to do it? You actually, good practice is that you should have one button tied up and keep it tied up. While you are coming in, it should be like this only. And you won't need to untie when you are sitting there. And you will be comfortable as well. Okay, so just a small thing which can avoid what happened today.
For more neatness, I think your hair must be slightly white or whatever, bright bright cream or something, you know. So you look better. Otherwise, you're a smart looking boy. Best of luck.
Thank you. Sir, I need to ask something.
Yeah.
Sir, last year I got very less marks. I only secured 130 marks. My marks in mains were very good and I could easily become an IAS officer.
Mains also was
good? Yes, I got around 860 marks and I could have taken around 180 to become an IAS officer.
Same optional?
Yes, sir. Physics is my optional for the last year.
How much did you get?
Sir, 130 marks.
In physics?
No, sir, not in physics. In physics, I got.
In physics, how much did you get?
310 marks, sir.
Up to 510.
Yes, mm-hmm. It was around 3rd or 4th highest in the country.
Did you expect that low?
In the interview, sir? No, sir.
No, in physics.
Physics marks, my marks in physics are good, okay. Sir. But in interview, I got only 130 marks out of 275.
Which pool was it?
Sir, P.K. Joshi, sir.
What do you think about the main reason?
I am trying to identify it, but I think there was some arguments there because some of the members were not listening and they were countering every point that I was saying.
That's a trick. That is a trick of mine.
I'm trying to, give you some stress.
Yes, and two members started laughing also, and whenever I was answering, one member from this side was saying something like this thing. Lots of things. I was really pressured.
They are not expected to behave in such a responsible manner. Tricks are, tricky questions are asked, but not in this derivative manner.
Sir, this happened with me. They asked me a question on Indian football, and I told them we don't pass, we don't have the strategy and everything. At some points I gave them. And then they converted the question that is it not Indian mentality that all of us are selfish in nature?
All of us are
selfish in nature, we cannot pass, we cannot work together. And the two members started laughing because the first member, he asked me questions on are all Indians dishonest, we have problems like this, nobody uses dustbins.
Sir, with your permission, but I feel basically they have a purpose. First of all, you should be very clear that the interview board is not at all, I am saying with great degree of confidence, is they are having anything negative. They are there to promote you, to help you come out in the best. But at the same time, they also want to test your emotional intelligence, integrity, because your cognitive intelligence has been tested to a large extent in your design. And this is the way they adopt. Otherwise, tell me how within half an hour's time they would be able to see whether you possess all those qualities of a civil servant or not. Mm-hmm. Asking a question doesn't, I ask you a question, you reply, you may not reply, doesn't matter. These are the situations they create, laughing, ridiculing you, making you irritated. So for the score, low score was that you responded in a very, very negative way. You fell into their trap.
So this could be a
reason. If again such things happen, you should be very positive. Very, very positive.
And you should remain polite. Politeness is very, very essential. Even if they laugh at you.
Doesn't matter. You also smile, you join them in smiling. By not laughing, by smiling. And feel confident and open. I don't think any interview board members, they are always positive. But these are techniques they use.
And the answering to that kind of a question, where do we lag? Actually, we have to answer in some, I would say, positive manner. We need to improve in this area. It could have been the same answer. Rather than saying that we don't do this, we can say, we need to improve in this area. So that doesn't give rise to the kind of comments that they need.
Rather, you should be positive. You should say, sir, this is, I think, more on the perception side.
So the first time we went up to this stage, we need to improve in this and we'll go further up. So that's a positive way of saying the same thing. Okay. But if you say it in a negative manner, we did not do this, then what actually happens is that it actually is showing your personality. Mm. Whenever you are talking about, they ask you some question, pros and cons, always start with pros.
Okay, sir.
Positive points.
But you see, my question is that it's okay, they give you stress, but making a mockery of the candidate is unethical.
It's not a Kapil Sharma show.
They themselves do not know how to interview. This is my view. I've seen so many interviews in UPSC. I've sat and I've conducted so many interviews in the mock interviews, also thousands. This has never happened. They might, but they never go to such an extent. SSC it could have happened, but not in UPSC. Then supposed to be. But take it in your stride. If at all something of similar nature happens, then take it in your stride. Don't get stressed. Basi also, Mr. Basi also seems that they are all impulsive in characters. They are not balanced minded people.
That's why they write.
In my first interview, I got gold of Basi, sir.
How much did you get?
Sir, 165.
Okay, that's your good luck.
165 is a good score.
Basi is very
always
stingy, remember. Otherwise 140 will be more than 140. But anyway, but did your board last year behave similarly with other candidates also? Did you talk to anybody else after?
No, sir, I didn't know anyone of them. Even in the medical, I couldn't find anyone. And I didn't even ask.
Naturally, it is very embarrassing.
So, all the best, I think.
And remember, this time when you go, be smarter than them.
Yes.
And always have this notion, because everybody has a salutation MR written, Mr. Satchitra, Mr. Basi, Mr. This. Remember, mockery and ridicule, MR.
Okay,
just beware of that.
Okay,
right?
Thank you, sir.
Have a smile.
Thank you, sir.